That must be the house. There is no other within many miles. But surely not. It's just an empty shell, devoid of life. A sterile outcrop of stone amid the mire. But there can be no doubt. This is the house. Yet it looks so dark, so forbidding, so dead. That great crumbling facade, windows just like vacant eyes that peer upon the stagnant, glistening blackness of the lake. I have never seen anything like it. The gloom, the rotting dankness of the place. It must be my imagination. The darkness and the cold. Yet still, far beneath the plane of thought and quiet against my will, my heart begins to tremble in mad anticipation of the house. And I am forced to recognize a consciousness of fear. A cold and senseless fear, nameless, formless, chilling to the bone. No, it's just the leaden air that makes me forget myself. The weather and the dusk. This must be all that sets my teeth on edge, and the hairs at the nape of my neck to attention. And what of his sister? This does not speak of her, but I understand she too lives with him here. In the house of Usher, home of the family, for 500 years or more. It's a strange place, a strange house. An even stranger clan. Or either saints or mad, not an ordinary man among them. Genius is all, but all time honored as it is, the Usher race has put forth no enduring branch. And so from sight to sound, from sight to sound, the patrimony and the name have passed. Through all their ancestry, no cousins, aunts, or bastards disturb the singular symmetry of the family tree. Well then, so I am here, I have come, and it is too late, too dark to run. But what a chilling sight, this palace crouching in the night. Are there a light? I am awaited, I am expected. I shall not disappoint my friend.